In this lesson, we will understand how we can create a Gaussian chart in Power BI. First, we will understand what is a Gaussian chart. Then we will create it under Power BI. We will also learn how to format it, add different colors and work around it. Let us start. So Power BI includes a lot of data visualization components. One of them is Gaussian chart. Okay, so a Gaussian chart easily displays information on a radial scale. You must have seen your car speedometer. It includes a needle that displays a scale, the current scale also while you are driving, and the maximum also. So the needle points to the current value within the predefined range. Okay. Or you can also display your percentage of the sales target using the Gaussian chart. Here is the example. We all know this speedometer in a car. This is the Gaussian chart. Right now the car is halted, so the speedometer is on zero. When it goes on, the speedometer increases accordingly, and the maximum limit is here. The same is written here. A Gaussian chart is a type of data visualization that displays a single value or a range of values related to a specific goal or target. Okay. So right now we have shown a basic example here. It is a circular or arc shaped. There is a needle or a pointer. Okay. Car speedometer is the best example. It displays the limit. Okay. It can be 120. Here it is 220. So in this lesson, we will see first how to create a Gaussian chart. Then we will format it. We will also change the Gaussian chart color, and the data labels will also be enabled to change the font, font color, units and others easily. Let us now create a Gaussian chart. So guys, if you remember, we successfully loaded our data. Here it is, my store. Okay. My store was the Excel workbook. We imported it. Now we will create a Gaussian chart. First, what I'll do, I'll save it. File, save as. You can save it at any location. Let's say I'll save it under documents. Okay, I'll name it. The extension of your Power BI file is .pbix. I'll name it, let's say, okay, Amit Power BI underscore Gaussian chart. Save. Now we have saved it. Here it is. Okay. Let us create our Gaussian chart. First, select sum of sales because we'll be using it to create our Gaussian chart. Just select it. Okay, if it's not visible data, you can click here. Collapse. Now it is visible here, data. Here it is. I'll click sales and it will automatically create a clustered column chart. Here it is. Okay, you can increase the size so that it is visible to you. You can also drag this here, or filters we'll check later. I'll click here. Now it's fine. Now we want to create a Gaussian chart. So just click here, and here are your visual charts, and you need to find the Gaussian chart. Okay, just beside your card on the left, you can see Gaussian. Click on it. Now this will convert to Gaussian chart. Here it is. Okay. Now what does this represent? We are not showing a needle right now, but what this basic Gaussian chart represents. This shows a Gaussian chart displaying the sum of sales. Okay. Here it is visible, sum of sales. We selected the same here. The Gaussian has a scale ranging from 0.0 to 1.45. Okay, here it is. The scale maximum, just like in your car. The Gaussian is partially filled with blue. Here it is, representing the current sales value, which is 725K around. Okay, so that's it. We can easily create our Gaussian chart. Now you would be wondering how to visualize it, how to change the color of this chart. Let's say I want to change the color. Select this, click on the visual here. Select this and click on here. This is format your visual. Here it is. Now, under visual, you need to click on colors. Here it is, visual colors. Right now it's this color. You can change it. Let's say I'll take it to the following, and now you can see we successfully changed it. Okay, or we can change it to any color. I just added this. I'll click here. Let's say I'll click this. Now this looks fine. Okay, so we successfully changed the color. Now what about the data labels? We can easily enable the data labels of the God chart and change the font, font color, display units and others. So for that, click here again and go to close this, go to data labels. It's on, that's why the data labels are visible, but we can also format it. Here the font is visible. You can change the color also. Okay, let's say I'll go to here and change the color to the following. Now the new color is visible. If you want to change the font value, it's only 12. I'll change it to 15. Let us change it to 10 and see the difference. It's very less. I'll change it to 18, let's say. How about this? Press enter and it's fine. If you want to set bold, italic and underline, you can do it. Okay. I'll close this. Now you can see the title is also visible. You can also change it. Go to journal, click title, it's on. It's 14. Let me change it to 22. Let's say here it is sum of sales. You can also change the heading. Let's say I'll set it to heading 2. It's fine. Now text you can change from here. You can also bold it. Let's say I'll click bold and now it looks amazing. Also set the background color alignment. You can also set subtitle, it's off, you can on it. You can also set a divider, effects and other things you can play around. Keep the mouse cursor and the tooltip is visible. You can also on or off the tooltip. So in this way guys, you can create a God chart and play around the visuals to make it more amazing. After that you can go to file and save it. Our file was amit_power_bi_godchart. So it was under documents. Okay, Amit Power BI God Chart and extension. We just created it. Okay, .pbix. So guys, we saw how we can easily create a God chart. We first understood what is a God chart with the speedometer example, and we created a basic God chart after that. We also changed the font, the color of the God chart, and did some other amazing stuff. Thank you for watching the video.